The Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, made the remarks in an interview after today's plenary session, where Parliament failed to receive a statement on the skyrocketing commodity prices that had been lined up on the order paper. Nabanja advised Ugandans to use their essential items at home sparingly as government finds a solution.
One, I want to inform the general public that the prices of commodities that are raising up is a global phenomenon. We have taken trouble to find out what is happening in our neighboring countries. The prices are going up. Why? Because all countries opened at the same time. So those companies, all factories in Indonesia, in Malaysia, China, they are overwhelmed by demand in all countries across the globe. Because you know, some of these raw materials do not come from here. So those raw materials that come are imported on a global demand. And therefore, that's one of the reasons why we have some prices going up. Then the second one is the speculators. Some people hold on the items they have and then start releasing them slowly. Because first of all, like you know, these other companies like Bidico, Mukwano, and many other companies that work, MM Park, we have had a meeting with them. And we have also, you can also go on net and check whether other countries, whether their prices are going up. You can check. It's a global phenomenon.
The Premier blamed the high prices on manufacturers hoarding commodities to create an artificial scarcity in order to justify exorbitant charges. She, however, explained that government is engaging them to address the crisis.
Is the speculators. Some people hold on the items they have and then start releasing them slowly. Because first of all, like you know, these other companies like Bidico, Mukwano, and many other companies that work, MM Park, we have had a meeting with them. And we have also, you can also go on net and check whether other countries, whether their prices are going up. You can check.
MPs were shocked when Parliament lasted for a short while and was adjourned unceremoniously, with only one out of the lengthy matters on the order paper tackled. MPs left disappointed, wondering why they were not given time to debate the government report on the increased prices of commodities in the country.
I don't know. I would be interested in establishing and knowing why exactly the Speaker adjourned the House. Unceremoniously, because our order paper had very critical issues to discuss, one of which is skyrocketing commodity prices, skyrocketing fuel prices, you know, and there were other, you know, issues on the order paper. For example, I had to present the Kosasa report on Uganda Railways Corporation, you know, but the Speaker skipped all of that, pulled out one item of the ministerial policy statements and said this is the only item. I was shocked because, you see, laying these statements takes a very short time, and as you saw, it took about 20 minutes, and the Speaker said, I've adjourned, sign, die.
Very unfortunate, because we expected to discuss and debate on solutions towards the ongoing inflation in our country, increase in prices of fuel, oil prices, increase in the prices of goods and services. And of course, we know inflation must be solved.
Some legislators have proposed changing administration of Parliament to provide for a panel of speakers of Parliament to avoid a vacuum.
That is the thing, the set of people that I was talking about. We need a panel of speakers so that in case the deputy is not around and the speaker is not around, then one of the people on the panel can basically chair the sitting, the plenary.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.